Okay, welcome to the end of week two of the Pandemic Vlog, week two of three. And today we have our second double-length replica of A Last Mountain Beat, written by Jeff Poliquin. I don't care if I got that name wrong, it's better than, yeah. We can basically call it one of a ripple effect where we have a replica of Nova Kingdom where Pandemic Gang, I don't know if I mentioned it, but Premier Ray established that they need the charge to make the thing that gave the parents. And the shard, each shard in a different world, and if the inner world of the shard, his thingy will glow green. Now, and again, mentioned they've been to a lot of worlds, and it hasn't glowed yet, so it's getting a little frustrated. So they go to a world where they must wrangle the mountain beast in order to save the town from ripping. You know, and it's glowing green, and now you have to birth his guide. It's a time-critical mission, so do a mission, save a bunch of people, we'll get this shard. So that is the cap for this one. And yeah, I really like this one. 22 minutes could have been cool as well for the show, and this can definitely quite a call one, I think. I'm not sure how compared to Ripple Fett is carried, but thinking for the same purpose with Penn, showing how desperate he is to get parent back on this one, it cuts a bit deeper because his first need is basically to go and get the shard, and it's a time to get mission because they have to do it before the fifth moon rising. I will say right away that I think Penn was a little too quick to want to do this instead of it being more original battle. That does make them seem a little diggish, but then the Emperor Progressing Way will certainly call him out on that and that, because I think his big thing would come from that. He basically ruined, get a lot of people killed, and in the end, he'd be like, wow, no, you're okay. and it's actually a really nice moment at the end where he'd be like, all the wrong thing he did. Okay. Yeah, I mean, they both acknowledge what he's doing wrong and can't really kind of understand what he did, but, it's actually a really cool thing we do in the episode with that, because it's like, he is desperate, and, he can get that shard and be able to repair him. I can't get to blame him, so, he can get over his head, again, you have a bunch of, bad things coming. He wants to divert the mission away, and so he tried to run away. And it's gonna cost you a check or tie him up. and I said, it's good, the circle joke people, they're pretty much the bulk of them, because they are trying to get to the point where they have to, win back or whatever. It'd take him a while because they are having weird rules. That's my favorite part of it, because there's a lot of funny jokes with that. And he would kind of make moments, which again, they don't end up adding up to anything, but they're going to make moments when you're there at. I like, at one point, one of the beasts give birth through his mouth, just throw it up. You're welcome for that anyways, but it's right then the episode. Yeah, blame me. that's pretty funny. I feel like we're all joking about it. We're more story focused, thank you, respect. But we've done a good joke there, too. I like the end thinger we do. That's one that I found funny. Actually, we've got to do this one because he had to coup pen check. At what point, we're going to have to at the end after we got Ken done that. Took a lot of things in perspective, and it was really nice. And again, I like what he did with Penn here, because before I was right gossiping a little, it was, Ripple Effect, they kind of did something similar where Penn kind of put things in danger because of, but this one had him going even a step further with that, so I guess the big question I can have that is pretty good Ripple Effect. To the point where that could became perfect, but it's then gonna be because of the focus on the setting, and again, how really different Penn, and again, that really nice moment with Kashi at the end. Which, it took me, I mean, so glad they haven't gone a Starco route with them. I mean, yeah, people can sit with them and play a fuel, but it's not like we're forcing it, you know? If they're aware of it, they'll leave that one Comic Con to make fun of it. It's a funny way to go. They are aware. Yeah, but they're having moments that are definitely there, but if you don't care about shipping and don't read into it, then the friend moment. So they could very well end up giving, I don't know, but they're not at all really pushing or even hinting anything that strong. Given it, I think Trevor, it won't definitely work and go shipping on it, but if you don't read that, then you have to. So that's good. You know, it could be so mostly not about that element, it's about bigger element, you know, go. You know, and we got a week or two left, one doubt we're gonna try and cram it in into our last week. It could, but I don't know. Bravo, yeah, a really good one. They got like little journey we do without being funny. We've been learning a lot of jokes, but best friend, like Kong, great. Boom, push for kind to a dent. That's not the deal with boom, 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 boom. But it got go. Again, kind of pushing, you know, apparently, you came in with that, but looking for because of how much immediate injury put in, and how, yeah, they have really enough point that took them laughing perspective, and, yeah, they could come on, you know, they can't really, that's why I'm having them, but they go, I understand, just don't, we go, you know. Yeah, really good one. For the, if I got Google, you can go, like, put at least on part of that premiere somewhat. No, often considered. Oh yeah, very good, very enjoyable, very nice. I leave put a part of the set, but I have to watch it and again so that you know. That one probably won't probably be going for a time. You know, the show kind of dressed. Like, depending on show that much, in King 1, they probably fairly periodically to remind us that they again. They're very good happen as much. Which I find interesting. I guess we know that about the, you know, so, like, we don't need to be reminded. So, yeah. I believe that's it for the last Mountain Bean. Again, we only have one big story to talk about. It's not about to get the Legion guys going. So, yeah, I did really like this one. Quite a bit. So, yeah, that ends week two. So, next week, on Monday, which will have all 5 days before we have to go, which is how a bomb should be. Pending one out of a bomb. So, okay. So, Monday, we have Ninky Ninja Fight Town / My Mystery Fun. Boy, one of them is an anime episode. Yay. Okay, for a reboot to get pissed off. They both got an A. Yeah, then we won't be built up, but I'll talk about that one. But in the meantime, on Saturday, Milo Murphy's video will come back with Mixing Milo, and finally Milo come back with a battle-long special thingy. Will it be very well brought to you? Guess we'll find out on Saturday, then return on Monday with Pem Hero. Also, MLP returns August 5th, you know, which is only a 2 weeks. Yeah, it's the week after the Pentagon go. We're gonna keep the train coming with vlogs. Yeah, so. And then again, I do have other idea for the show that I want. There'll probably be one I start in my channel, LP again. Oh, and I did a calculation again, LP will still be airing up cook when the movie comes out. So. But yeah, that's all I got for the cup going. Very good, it's a little similar and quite a good one. So I shall see you Saturday for Mixing Milo and Monday for Anime Hero. So, see you then.